Welcome to Mental Health Mini number 32, where we will discuss the types of therapy that individuals can receive. The first type is group therapy. Group therapy is often run by a social worker, a psychiatrist, a psychologist, or a nurse practitioner. It can also be a self-led group, such as with AA, which is Alcoholics Anonymous, Narcotics Anonymous, and other self-help groups. The purpose of group therapy is to allow individuals to discuss their feelings and experiences with peers. In doing so, they can improve their feelings of support, they can have different perspectives to problems that they may be trying to process, they will receive encouragement, accountability, hope, and catharsis. The main thing with group therapy as the facilitator is that you would want to monitor for any non-therapeutic interactions. Psychoeducation therapy is often run by a nurse or a provider. It is larger in size than other forms of group therapies, and it focuses on providing patients and families with education on the different disorders, especially symptoms, the different treatments, especially medication education, how to manage symptoms outside of medications, how to support individuals that are experiencing those symptoms, and different resources both for the patient and the family. Family therapy is often conducted by a social worker, psychiatrist, or psychologist. This includes any relevant family members to help and addresses symptoms to restore family functioning. Cognitive behavioral therapy is a form of psychotherapy, and psychotherapy is one-on-one therapy between a patient and either a social worker or a therapist. And in psychotherapy, they identify different problems and work through those problems. Cognitive behavioral therapy is one approach to working through those problems. It is often conducted by social workers, psychiatrists, psychologists, or nurse practitioners. A registered nurse can also support and encourage cognitive behavioral techniques in their care as well. This can be done in individual or group therapy, and the purpose is to identify any thought distortions and learn how to reorient those thoughts. As a result, we would see an improvement in mood as well as behavioral changes. So it ultimately challenges maladaptive thoughts like personalization, all or nothing thinking, mind reading in the sense that they're assuming that other people are thinking one thing or another about them, discounting positives, overgeneralizing situations, and using emotional reasoning instead of logical reasoning to react to different problems. Cognitive behavioral therapy takes a lot of work, and that may be frustrating for a lot of patients. So it's really important as nurses that we're encouraging them to follow through with the different techniques. Then we have activity therapy. This is conducted by an activity therapist, and it encourages participation in action and movements to help individuals face their problems and symptoms of mental illness. It aims to improve social interactions, confidence, interest in activities, and structure. Different ways that activity therapy can be conducted is through mindfulness techniques, exercise, gardening, games, sport or recreational games, cooking, and therapeutic outings. Pet therapy is another therapy where the individual interacts with an animal for stress relief and coping. The animal must be trained for therapy. And this is especially beneficial to individuals with social anxieties. The animals may differ based on the patient's needs and preferences, but commonly we find that horses are very beneficial in the treatment of patients with autism. Dogs are most commonly used in the hospital setting, and cats can be very effective with pet therapy too, although they're often used through the individual having that animal as a pet themselves. Occupational therapy is a form of therapy conducted by an occupational therapist to help patients recover or develop skills that are beneficial and necessary for meaningful activities, self-care, and functioning within society. These may include skill development and identifying resources to assist with ADLs and other activities. This is most beneficial for patients that have a traumatic brain injury or neurocognitive disorders. Examples of things that can be done in occupational therapy is helping a patient find a shower chair or a rail to help them with ADLs. We may do range of motion or fine motor activities to help build strength and dexterity. We can also help a patient to determine the order of getting dressed or assistance with getting dressed so that they can better perform their ADLs on their own. Music therapy is conducted by a music therapist, and it's beneficial for patients across the spectrum of mental health disorders, but especially in individuals with depression, anxiety, and neurocognitive disorders. In music therapy, we may play music for calming effect. We may play music for retrospection and thought provocation, reminiscent therapy, or we can encourage patients to participate in making music. Lastly, we have art therapy. Or actually, no, first we have art therapy, then we'll have play therapy, which will come last. So art therapy may be conducted by an art therapist or a recreational therapist. It's very effective in the treatment of anxiety and depression. And it includes things like crafting to assess the patient for comprehension, focus, and direction following while providing coping skills and helping to build self-esteem. We can have them analyze others' artwork for retrospection and thought provocation. Or we can have them create art to express their feelings and engage in coping. On the left, you'll see a circle. This is called Mandela art. And what we found in some studies is that if patients engage in Mandela art, where they either color in these circles or create the designs within for 30 days, it may be as effective in reducing symptoms of anxiety and depression as an antidepressant. Then lastly, we have play therapy. So this is often conducted by a social worker, a psychiatrist, a psychologist, or a nurse practitioner. In order to conduct play therapy, we use different tools in play to help the individual express their feelings, resolve conflicts, and understand and comprehend situations. This is most commonly used to treat children who have experienced trauma, but it can also be effective in treating those with eating disorders. Theater therapy is a form of play therapy where we have the individual act out different emotions to help them express and process what they're going through. And that is our mental health mini on different types of therapies.